Hello everyone, this is Ashish Jain. In this video, I will explain you the characteristics of a company in brief with some case laws. Earlier, we have studied all the characteristics and one of the important characteristics is separate legal entity. As the name suggests that the company has its own identity and it is distinct from the natural persons. Even it is also legal because it is registered under Companies Act. Now, if we see the definition, it is defined as the artificial person having separate legal entity and perpetual succession. See, separate legal entity means that the company is totally distinct from the natural person, and perpetual succession means that the company will go forever. It has no physical existence, hence it is intangible. An AOP, that is Association of Person, duly registered under the Act, run by professionals who is called Board of Directors, and the people who invest, they are called shareholders. Now, we need to understand this point. Why? Because we need to see why this principle came. And what are and we need to actually see what is the objective behind to implement this principle. Which principle? That is separate legal entity. Now, in this principle, we will discuss legal entity, that the company separate from its member, and company has its own name, rights and liabilities. Rights and liabilities in the sense, company has its own responsibility. And various assets, that means company can purchase any assets in its own name. Now we will let's discuss this principle in more detail with this famous case, that is, which is Salomon versus Salomon Company Limited. See, there was a same a person who's called who was Salomon. He basically started his shoemaking business, and later on he introduced his fortune into business. Over the time, the business went go very well, and the Salomon thought to convert this sole proprietor business into company. So what he has done, he incorporated a company with the name of Salomon Company Limited, and then later on this company acquired the sole proprietor business, that is this business, with a consideration of £38,000. Now, in this company, there are basically these are the members. Who are the members? His wife and his four sons. And these members are also shareholders. They have they actually hold one share each. And this Salomon itself a director of a company. Okay. Now, one of the weird situation is he is also a secured creditor of the company. Why? Because he has purchased debentures of £10,000 of that company. Now, over the time, the company went into liquidation, where the value of the assets was £6,000 and the liabilities were £16,000. Now, as you know very well, at the time of liquidation, the company should pay first to secured creditors. Okay, so one of the unsecured creditor filed a case against a company that the whole family running its company, and the amount from selling of the assets should be paid first to him. He actually files in a court because he was thinking, and he was saying actually that the whole family running its company, family mein dekhi kaun kaun tha, wife and four sons. Okay, now अब इस मुझे कोर्ट का देखिए वर्डिक्ट क्या है, यानी कंपनी ने यानी कि कोर्ट ने क्या फैसला सुनाया, दैट द कंपनी इज अ सेपरेट लीगल एंटिटी दस सिक्योर क्रेडिटर विल बी पेड फर्स्ट वंस मिस्टर सलमान हु इज नेचुरल पर्सन स्टार्टेड द कंपनी विच इज कॉल्ड आर्टिफिशियल पर्सन बोथ ऑफ देम आर सेपरेट पर्सन ओके सो दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड सेपरेट लीगल एंटिटी कोर्ट सेड दैट द कंपनी एंड द सिक्योर क्रेडिटर्स आर टोटली डिफरेंट दे आर डिस्टिंक्ट फ्रॉम ईच अदर सो एज पर द लॉ सिक्योर क्रेडिटर विल बी पेड फर्स्ट ओके नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट दैट इज हाउ अ कंपनी सेपरेट फ्रॉम इट्स मेंबर्स Now again, we will understand this topic by a famous case that is Lee versus Lee Air Farming. अब देखिए इस केस में क्या है मिस्टर ली ये कौन है देखिए ये मिस्टर ली है कौन है ये हु वॉज एक्चुअली क्वालिफाइड एयर पायलट एंड देन लेटर ऑन ही कन्वर्ट हिज प्रोफेशन इंटू बिजनेस एंड फॉर्म्ड अ कंपनी विद अ नेम ऑफ ली एयर फार्मिंग कंपनी लिमिटेड विद अ विद 3,000 शेयर्स नाउ आफ्टर इनकॉर्पोरेटिंग द कंपनी मिस्टर ली मेंशन इन द आर्टिकल्स दैट द चीफ पायलट विल रिसीव सैलरी एंड हु इज द चीफ हु इज द चीफ पायलट मिस्टर ली हिमसेल्फ देन Mr. Lee was actually dead because of plane crash and then his widow wife claimed from the insurance company to compensate £2,400 as per Employee Compensation Act. The company has insurance company for all its employees. Then Insurance company claims that the company's director, owners, members, employees are all same person who has taken insurance policy. So, Lee's wife should not be compensated. He actually later on, the insurance company later on claim. Okay. Now, what is the decision in this case by the court? The court has made its decision that the company is a separate legal entity and the Mr. Lee, who was an employee as well, once Mr. Lee started the company, both of them, including his wife, are separate persons. Okay, so that means company is totally distinct from its members. Both the cases are very important from the examination point of view as well. Okay, so in this case, यानी कि that means जो सोलोमन वर्सेज सोलोमन केस है इसमें क्या हमने देखा that the जो की कंपनी जो अनसिक्योर्ड क्रेडिटर उसने क्लेम किया था कि पहले पहले अमाउंट जो है उसको पे पेमेंट उसको मिलनी चाहिए एट द टाइम ऑफ लिक्विडेशन बट देखिए कोर्ट का जो वर्डिक्ट क्या आया कि दैट द सिक्योर्ड क्रेडिटर शुड बी पेड फर्स्ट एज पर द Laws, okay, because companies and the Mr. Solomon, that is natural person, are both of them are separate person. And the second case, that is Lee versus Lee Air Farming, इसमें क्या क्या कहा that the insurance company ने यहाँ पर claim किया था that the companies and the members are all same person, but the verdict of the court. Is that the company is a separate legal entity and they are totally distinct from its members. Okay, thank you.